The Gesture SDK enables you to use motion to interact with your device. Hi, I'm Vincent, and we hope you enjoyed our previous episodes. In this tutorial, we will learn the basics of the Gesture SDK and then create a sample application that recognizes hand gestures. The Gesture SDK was developed to augment touch or motion events. It enables users to utilize events that are generated by hand movements in front of the gesture sensor on the upper right corner of the Samsung smart device. Some of the uses of the Gesture SDK includes answering incoming calls, navigating through the pages of e-books, activating voice commands, and other variants of launching application responses based on hand movement. To develop for the Gesture SDK, we will need the following. First, we'll need an Eclipse with ADT plugin. Jelly Bean or API level 18 is the minimum requirement to use the Gesture SDK. Second, we are required to have these jar files as well. These can be found in the mobile SDK 1.5 archive file. And lastly, prepare a Samsung device that has Android 4.3 or higher. Also check whether your Samsung smart device has a gesture sensor. Due to hardware issues, Gesture cannot be used with the Galaxy S4. For this example, we will go ahead and use the Galaxy S5. Before we create our sample application, let's take a look at the architecture and classes of the Gesture SDK. The architecture consists of three layers. The applications layer, which refers to one or more applications that make use of Gesture. The second layer is the Samsung API that contains Gesture and S-Context. Gesture is the main component that recognizes hand gestures. As for S-Context, these are gesture components that provide motion with gesture events. And lastly, at the very bottom, we have the Android API. Let's go ahead and talk about two main classes for the Gesture SDK. The first class is the S-Gesture. This is the entry class that provides access to the gesture package. This class provides methods for initializing the gesture package and for checking whether the gesture feature is supported. To initialize S-Gesture, we can refer to the code displayed on the screen. You can make use of the illegal argument exception to resolve issues that pertain to null listeners or invalid types. For example, this may eventually correspond to the start and is feature enabled methods. For SSDK unsupported exception, the important exception message is to handle are vendor not supported for non-Samsung devices and device not supported for devices which do not support gesture. Other exception messages indicate whether installation or an update is recommended or required. The S-Gesture Hand class provides the hand movement recognition functionality. It uses a gesture sensor placed in the top right side of the device. When you move your hand above the device, you can get the movement details, like timestamp, direction, and angle, in your application. Take note that the hand movement is only captured when the screen is on. This class contains two nested classes, S-GestureHand.ChangeListener, which is an interface that receives hand gesture events, and sgesturehand.info, which is a class that contains the hand gesture event information and provides methods to access it. Essentially, the sgesturehand class recognizes hand movement using device sensors. Now that we're familiar with the classes that we need, let's start creating our application. Let's name our application Simple Gesture. Set the minimum and target SDK to API 18, then proceed. Select blank activity. Then import the jar files in the library folder and include the Write Use App Feature Survey Manifest permission. If you're creating this application for Android 4.3, it's okay to leave out this manifest. However, for Android 4.4.2 or KitKat and above, a security exception is thrown, and your application won't work properly if you do not include this. Moving on, I updated my ADT, that's why the layer contains an auto-generated fragment. Let's separate that to another class. I'd call it mainActivityView.java. Now edit the fragment main.xml. Instead of hello world displayed on the text view, we'll put the degrees information here. This will contain the angle information of the gestures performed. Add another text view. This will reflect the direction of the performed gesture. Add the following string responses inside strings.xml. Before we begin, let's create a class and name it Gesture Hand. This is where we will initialize as Gesture Hand. Let's add the following variables. On the constructor, let's instantiate the S gesture hand. Let's create four methods, namely setListener, start, stop, and getDirection. On the set listener, let's simply set the listener. On the start method, let's simply call the start of our sGesture object. On the stop method, let's call the stop method of the sGesture hand. And finally, the get direction. This will simply take the angle of the gesture and will calculate its direction. Open the mainActivity.java. Then let's declare the things we need. Inside the onCreate method, we initialize the mGesture and mGestureHand classes like so. As we can see here, we have an error for change listener because we haven't added it yet. We can simply call the change listener. But before that, let me tell you more about the hand primitive type. The hand primitive gesture type helps recognize hand gestures and return gesture data. When the user moves the hand above the gesture sensor, you can get the hand gesture details. Use the sGestureHand.info.getAngle method to get the angle of the hand at the endpoint of the gesture. The image displayed indicates how gesture recognizes angles. Going back to our code, we add the change listener. By calling the change listener and overriding the onChange method inside it, we are telling our application that every time someone performs a hand gesture stroke, we get the angle and indicate the direction by updating the text view in our layout. Let's override the onStart method and check if the gesture functionality is supported. If it is, let's change the messages played to the user as supported. Then override the onDestroy method and call. It's best that we call this method when we aren't using the mGestureHand class. And we're done! The sample application is included in this blog post. For those viewing directly from YouTube, you can go to developer.samsung.com and check out the tutorial entries. Let's go ahead and test our application. Open the application. Gestures are recognized only when the screen is active. Now, let's perform any gesture we like. As we can see here, the text views are updated with the respective labels for angle and direction. Let's go ahead and summarize the things we've discussed in creating the basic application that uses gesture. Always include the necessary SDK jar files in your project. Check if the device supports the Gesture SDK. Validate if the device has motion sensor and check the OS of the device. It must have Jelly Bean API 18 or higher. Implementing this through code would be calling the SSDK unsupported exception or is feature enabled. And lastly, don't forget to put in the necessary manifest permissions. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Thanks for watching.